Almost everyone suffers from chronic pain sometime in their life. In most cases, this pain is related to dysfunctional muscle cells called trigger points. Being able to identify these trigger points causing your pain can help you treat it with self-massage and light stretching or by visiting a qualified professional. Trigger points are not only the cause of pain, but in some cases can also cause bizarre symptoms like ringing in the ear, constipation, or migraines. A trigger point can be felt on your body as a small knot on a tight band of muscles. When this point or knot is pressed, you will feel excruciating pain. Trigger points can form on any skeletal muscle of the body. Some muscles can have more than one trigger point, and you could have multiple trigger points in various muscles of your body. Because a trigger point restricts the ability of a muscle to lengthen, it creates mechanical tension at the point of its attachment at the joints. Sometimes, causing pain further up in the chain of muscles. This phenomenon is called referred pain. For example, a trigger point on the lower trapezius muscle, as shown here, can cause neck pain and headaches. Since the 1960s, researchers have been discovering and documenting the relationship between pain patterns and specific trigger points. Painalog's pain map covers more than 120 paired skeletal muscles, 150+ trigger points, and 300+ pain patterns that will help you identify the most likely cause of your pain using advanced 3D mapping. To understand the cause of a trigger point, we need to take a closer look at a muscle. A trigger point is a small knot in your muscle of the size of a pinhead or a pea. The knot itself forms on a taut band of muscle that moves and snaps under your touch like a guitar string. As we zoom in, we can see a muscle is composed of several muscle fibers. Each of these fibers are composed of linked sections called sarcomeres. Sarcomeres are where all the action happens in the muscle. They contract and lengthen due to complex and rapid cellular change triggered by arriving nerve signals. However, when they do not have enough energy in the cell, the sarcomere loses the ability to release itself and is forced into a shortened and locked state. To compensate for the shortening, the sarcomeres up and down the fiber are pulled taut. Typically, this phenomena will occur on adjacent muscle cells, thus creating a small knot-like object on your muscle, which you now know as a trigger point. A trigger point accumulates chemicals of an inflammatory response and is extremely painful to touch. The good news is that trigger points, especially new ones, are easy to release if you have a little bit of patience and a good understanding of the location of the trigger point. Painalog will do most of this hard work for you by identifying your potential trigger point and even providing you with videos on how to locate them with your hand. Finally, all you need is a tool like a ball or stick. With this app, we will show you many techniques for release using simple tools you can find at home or purchase at a local store. The easiest technique to release a trigger point is to use static pressure by applying a steady, focused, and gentle amount of force on the trigger point without moving. Let's take a closer look at how that works. Applying pressure on the trigger point generates a sensation of pain. In response, a chemical called encephalin is released in the spinal cord, which not only suppresses the sensation of pain, but also causes the motor nerve attached to the trigger point to relax, causing palpable softening of the muscle cell and therefore a reduction in the number of shortened sarcomeres. Finally, when you release the pressure, new blood rushes in and removes the toxicity from the muscle cells and re-energizes it. When managing your muscle and joint pain is easy, you can go back to living life well. Enjoy the app. Be gentle with yourself and seek help when you are not sure. Thank you for watching. This is Team Painalog.